Hello viewers, welcome back. I am Neha Paryani. In today's session, we will discuss about bills of exchange. So let's start.
Fourth problem on bills of exchange. In the earlier sessions, we have already discussed three problems of this chapter, right? So in every problem, the situation was different. In the first problem, we have discussed what will be the journal entries if we retain the bill with ourselves. It means that if the drawer retains the bill with himself till maturity date. Okay. In the second problem, the situation was if the drawer gets the bill discounted by the bank, then what will be the journal entries, right? Then in the third problem, the situation was endorsement of bill. It means that if the drawer endorses the bill or transfers the bill to some other person, then what will be the journal entry for endorsing the bill? Okay, so today we are going to discuss the fourth problem. So if you want the link for the previous problems, then you can get it in the description box below, right? In today's problem, the situation is sending bills to bank for collection, right? So here what happens is the drawer sends the bill to the bank for collection. So when the maturity date arrives, the bank will collect the bills on behalf of drawer from the drawee. Okay, so the reasons for this transferring or sending the bills to bank can be anything. It could be security also. Okay, so when the maturity date arrives, the drawee has to pay the amount to the bank instead of paying the amount to the drawer. Okay, so now let's have a look at the problem. On 1st September 2018, Shama draws a 2 months bill on Dhama for rupees 3000. Here Shama is drawing a bill on Dhama. So Shama becomes the drawer, right? So and Dhama is drawing, which was accepted by Dhama. So Dhama accepts this bill. It means that he agrees to pay the amount on the maturity date, right? Then Shama sends it to bank for collection on the due date. Here Shama, drawer, is sending the bill to the bank, right? The bill was met by Dhama on maturity. Pass the journal entries in the books of Shama and Dhama. So here we are asked to prepare the journal entries in the books of Shama, that is drawer, and Dhama, that is drawee. Okay. So we know the format of journal entries, right? Journal entries in the books of Shama. We have date columns, particulars, ledger folio, debit amount column and credit amount column. Similarly, we have journal entries in the books of Dhama, that is drawee. Again, we have date column, particulars, ledger folio, debit and credit amount columns. Okay. So the first entry is Shama draws a 2 month bill on Dhama. So first of all, we need to make the journal entry for drawing a bill, right? So in the books of Shama, mention the date on 1st of September. So before making the journal entry, we should always remember a rule. That is, if assets increase, we always debit it, okay, and if assets decrease, we credit it, and if liabilities increase, we credit it, and if liability decreases, we debit it. Okay, so it's vice versa. Remember this. Okay, this will be helpful for making the journal entries. Now when Shama draws a bill on Dhama, it means that Shama is going to have bills receivable with him, right? His bills receivable will increase now, right? So bills receivable is one of the assets, and when asset increases, we debit it, right? So we need to debit bills receivable account in the books of Shama, right? So let's record it. On 1st September 2018, bills receivable account debtor to, now which account should be credited? The person from whom he is going to receive the bills or receive the amount, that person's account will be credited. Okay, so here it's Dhama's account, and the amount is rupees 3000 on both the sides. Right narration being bills drawn on Dhama. Right. Next, in the question it is given that which was accepted by Dhama. It means that Dhama accepts the bill. Now we need to make journal entry for accepting the bill, right? So when Dhama accepts to pay the amount in the future, it means that he is creating bills payable for himself, right? And when new liability is created, it means that our liability is increasing, right? So when liability is increasing, we need to credit it, right? When bills payable account is credited, which account should be debited? The person to whom he has to pay the bills, his account will be debited, right? So the journal entry in the books of Dharma will become Shyama's account debtor to bills payable account, okay? Again, on the same date, 1st of September 2018, Shyama's account debtor to bills payable account. Amount rupees 3000 on both the sides. Narration being bills accepted to pay. Okay. Next. Shyama sends it to bank for collection on the due date. Here Shyama is sending the bill to the bank, right? So here bills, again bills receivable is an asset, but here in this case the bills receivable is increasing for bank, right? Bank is going to receive the bill, right? So bank's asset will be increased. Now which account should be debited? We will not debit bank's account, okay? We will debit bank's for collection of bills account, okay? We need to write in full. We just cannot write bank account debtor, because when we write bank account debtor, it means that the balance in our bank is increasing. But here we are just transferring the bill to bank. Still our balance has not yet increased, right? So we need to write even in full. That is bank for collection of bills account debtor to bills receivable account, right? Because our bills receivable is reducing. We are passing it to bank. It means that our bills receivable is reducing, right? So when asset decreases, we need to credit it, okay? So the journal entry here becomes, on 1st September, bank for collection of bills account debtor to bills receivable account. Amount is rupees 3000 again. Remember, here don't just write bank account, okay? Because still our bills have not cleared yet, okay? We have just transferred the bills, right? Narration being bill sent to bank for collection. Now there will be no entry in the books of drawer, because drawer is nowhere connected here. The transaction is made between drawer and bank only, and here we are not preparing bank account. So only one journal entry we need to pass for this transaction. Okay, next, the bill is met by Dharma on maturity. Bill is met by Dharma, it means that when the maturity date has arrived, Dharma has made the payment. Okay, so now we need to make the entry for the payment, right? So to whom Dharma is paying the amount? Dharma is paying to bank, right? So here bank is the receiver. Now what the bank will do? Bank will receive the amount which is mentioned in the bill, and bank will deposit into our bank account. It means bank will deposit the amount into Shyama's bank account, right? Here the role of bank was only to accept the money from Dharma and then deposit to the Shyama's account. Bank will not keep the amount with himself. Okay, so here what the journal entry will be now? See, Shyama's bank account, bank balance is increasing, right? Because bank is depositing amount in the bank account of Shyama. So bank balance of Shyama is increasing. Bank balance is again an asset. When asset increases, we debit it, right? And what account will be credited? See, earlier we have sent the bills to bank. Now this account will be credited, because we are receiving back the bills. Now the bill don't have any value because the payment has already been made. So earlier we have debited it, now we should credit it, right? Here the date will change. See, now we need to make the journal entry on the maturity date. Now what will be the maturity date? The term of the bill is for 2 months, right? So from 1st September to 2 months, it will be 1st November, right? So, and on 1st November, we need to add 3 extra grace days, right? In every situation, we need to add this. So this grace days we add if in case the drawee is unable to pay the amount on the 1st of November, then 3 extra days will be given to him so that he can pay the amount. So here our maturity date becomes 4th of November, right? On 4th November, in the books of Shama, 4th November, bank account will be debited, right? Because our bank balances are increasing. Bank account is debited to bank for collection of bills account. Okay. And narration B, the bill collected by bank. Right. Amount is rupees 3000 again on both the sides. Rupees 3000. Okay. Now in the books of drawee, see here, Dhama is paying the bill, right? Earlier he had the liability to pay the bill, so we have credited it, right? When he had liability to pay the bills, it means bills payable was credited. Now his liability is reducing because he is paying the amount. So now the bills payable account will be debited because his liability is reducing, right? So now bills payable account is debited. And which account should be credited? See, on 4th of November, bills payable account is debited to, he is making the payment in the form of cash, right? So cash account will be credited because cash is an asset. When cash reduces, it will, when asset reduces, it will be credited, right? So cash account is credited. Amount rupees 3000. Narration will be being paid cash on due date. Okay, so are you clear? See, when he had to pay the bills, that means he had liability. So we have credited it. When Dhama has paid the amount, it means his liability has reduced. So we are debiting the bills payable account. And he is paying in the form of cash. So cash is reducing. When asset reduces, we always credit it. Okay. So this is how we make the journal entries in the situation when the bills will be sent to the bank for collection. Okay. In my next session, I will be discussing about dishonoring of bills. Okay. So that is a very important topic from this chapter. So please don't forget to watch the next upcoming sessions also.
Okay guys, so this was all about today. If you found this helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Till that, happy learning.